Alright, so with our movement system, the way it works is it's more complicated than just run and walk and stuff. So we need to fix that. As you can see in here, here's our running blend. So as I cycle through it, as you can see, he's got blends that go in different directions. See that? So we need to basically come up with all these animations for all the characters. Okay, so I'm going to show you guys how to do that. I'm going to go ahead and start with Mr. Vampire Dude here. Okay? He looks like this. And what I'm going to do is, just to make things super simple, I'm just going to right-click on this guy and go to... Let's see, I'll delete him out of here. Right-click on this guy and go to Asset Actions Export. So I'm going to export him out of Unreal. I'll just put him on the desktop. Okay. Then I'm going to go into Mixamo and upload him. And while that's happening, I'm just going to walk through some of this stuff. Okay, so this is the blending system here, okay? And I hold shift. If I move my mouse around here, nothing happens, but if you hold shift, you can blend through the animations. We're only focused on runs for vampires, so all of the runs are at the top here. The way you get to this is you go into Content, Animations, Base Humanoid, Blend Spaces, and it's the center one here called Humanoid Rifle Stand, okay? And if you hold shift, you can cycle through all these. And you can mouse over them, and it'll tell you what they are. Rifle, this one's run backwards loop. This one's strafe run 135. Strafe run left loop. Anyway, you can see what they are, but basically, you need to mimic these animations for the vampires without holding the rifles. Okay? Now, some of our other characters are going to be a little bit more difficult. For example, the Holy Knight and the like all the base vampires should be pretty easy. Each one of you guys could probably do one of those. The Holy Knight and the Vampire Lord are gonna have weapons, so they're gonna need to do this stuff and hold weapons. Okay. Anyway, so basically we need to come up with 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 animations here. The first one, I'm sorry, eight animations. The good news is Mixamo provides a lot of these for free. For example, run loop, okay. Back run loop, okay. And then left run and right run. We get those for free, okay. Which is really easy. So let's go to Mixamo here. So I'm just going to type in run, and we'll go ahead. There was one I was using which was called the standard run. It was pretty good. Just search for it. There we go. So this one here, and remember, we always want it to run in place. Right. Now, one of the things you got to take into consideration is whatever animations you get, they all have to be the same frame range. Okay? When you're doing this, all of these are all the same. These are like 19 frames a piece. So they all have to be, like, for example, this is 22, they all have to be 22. So you download that. And I've already downloaded these. Standard run, I got a running backward, right strafe and left strafe. Okay, so running backward. I think it was this one. Remember, they gotta be in place. So this one's 19 frames. So for this one, we want it to match the other one, which was 22. So we would decrease it until it says 22 frames. Decrease the overdrive until it says 22 frames. Okay? That way it matches up. Download that. And then I had like strafe. I got this one. This one's 20 frames. So I'm just gonna decrease the overdrive to 22.
I wasn't able to get rid of lines even when I'm
All right, we'll figure it out here in a second. Right, so now the other animations are gonna be a little harder to get. These, like, we don't get these for free, like Run 35, and basically what it is, if you look at these, it's like a diagonal run that way, a diagonal run that way, a backwards diagonal run, and a backwards diagonal run. So it's four animations, where backwards he's running at diagonals, and forwards he's running at diagonals. So we need to invent those. So the way we invent those is a little complicated, but I'll show you how to do it. All right, so first things first, I'm going to go ahead and import that character I downloaded from Mixamo. Well, actually, let's go in here, and I'm going to click download from Mixamo. So let's download this guy. Well, hold on. Let's close this out. So when he's in a T-pose, you want to download him. T-pose is fine. And I actually already downloaded him, but we'll just use that guy for... So I'm going to go into Maya, go to my downloads folder, and bring in Mr. Vampire here, okay? Now, let's go ahead and bring in the animation. So we use the Mixamo tool here. I'm going to go to Import Animation to Control Rig. And let's go ahead and pull in the only ones we're going to work with are running backwards and running forwards. Okay? So let's pull in the standard run here. Alright, so here he is running forwards. Okay? 22 frames long. I'm just going to change the frame range here because Mixamo, or the FBX exporter, only exports with this thing pushed all the way. So. 22, there we go. 22 frames long. Alright, so he's running forwards. So out of this, if I look at this from the top view, in my different views here, he's running forwards here. So I need a run diagonal this way and a run diagonal this way. Okay, so I'll show you how to get that. It's quite easy. So I'm going to just click 4 here and grab the hips. Okay. Now, I'm going to go into my Windows Animation Editor's Graph Editor, okay? And you have the rotates. Here's all the frames for the animation, okay? I'm going to select all the frames for the animation. And we want to use rotates here. So looks like the green one here is going to rotate. So I'm going to grab this, and I'm going to hit W to move, and then if I hold shift, it's going to rotate all of the frames along an axis. And as you can see, that's not the right way we want to rotate, so let's try a different one here. Let's try rotate, yeah, that's right, it's rotate Z, okay? So I'm going to look in this view here, and I'm going to rotate this. It needs to be rotated like 45 degrees, okay? So up in here, I can select all those frames, and I can type in 45. See how that rotates 45 degrees? Now, here's the good news. The good news is we have him rotated 45 degrees running here, but he's not facing forward. This is where it gets a little tricky, okay? So what I'm going to do is I'm going to come in here, and I'm going to select his spines, 1, 2, and 3. I shift selected all the spines, and you can see them here in the graph editor, all right? So I'm going to look at my top view here. So I'm going to select the rotate Zs, control select all the rotate Zs here, and then select it. Tap W, and then hold shift. And then rotate that. And they all rotate together, but again, I've picked the wrong axes. So let's try rotate Y. Select them all and hold shift. That's what we want. So now you can see I'm rotating all the frames so that he faces forward. Okay? You probably want to do this on like frame one. Not be dumb like me. So now he's facing forwards. Alright, so now let's take a look at how this looks. Alright. So he's running and facing forwards. And there's a little bit of a problem here. He's kind of like bent that way, which doesn't look too terrible, I guess. Actually, I don't hate that. I actually don't hate that at all. Another cool thing that you could do is his head is all kind of all over the place. Which actually isn't bad. I don't care about that. So that's it. So he's rotated. By looking at him from the top view, we got him rotated this way. Alright? So then we just export the animation normally. So let's save this scene, of course. So I'll go ahead and go into my Vampire Assault directory. Atomic Assault, Art, Character, Vampires, Vampire Dude. And in here, I'm just going to type in, this is like, let's call this, I think this one is Run 45, I think. So Run, let's just call it Run 45, okay? Yeah, save. All right. Now let's export it. So file, we'll just do export all, desktop, FBX. Now when we do this, we only care about animations. So we're going to turn on animation, don't need blend shapes. Actually, don't need deformed models at all. We're just exporting animation. 1 to 22. Should be able to just leave as is. So we'll call this Run 45, okay? Export all. So basically, that process you would go through and you would do the Run 45, the Run 35, then you would import the Run backwards animations and you would do the same thing. So where he's backwards 45 and backwards 135 or whatever it is, okay? And then you would have 8 animations. So right now we start off, we have 4 animations. By creating those other 4, we'd have the additional 4 that we need, which is Run 45, Run 135, Back Run 45, and Back Run 135. Okay? It's going to give us these 8 animations. So now let's jump into Unreal. Alright? So what we're going to do is I'm going to right-click on this this character here, this humanoid rifle stand, and then I'm going to retarget these over to the vampire. There's a problem, though. Actually, there's not a problem. Alright, so let's find him. So, vampire dude. Retarget. Okay, so it creates a bunch of animations. We don't actually need all these animations. We only need the runs. So, let's fire this up again. Alright, so we need run, rifle run, backwards loop. We basically just need runs. Strafe. Actually, let's just leave them. We can deal with them later. Okay, so rifle run backwards loop. What did we do? We did the run. Run where he's running this way diagonally, so he's facing, his legs are facing left diagonal, which is going to be this one here, which is run 45. I guessed right. Awesome. So let's go find run 45 in here. So when I double click on this, here's the loop for this guy, right? So he's got a crap load of animations in here. So let's go find run 45, which is... Why does he have duplicate animations? Hey Dan, do you know why when I push this over he has duplicate animations for everything? Oh, maybe I've already done it. Oh, well, I haven't done it actually. Oh, I guess I did do it. Where the hell are those animations?
Those are the old ones from yesterday, probably.
I didn't push them, though.
I mean, they're probably still existing. They were probably still there.
What?
Movement?
Not in there. That's really weird. Let's just try that again. Right click on this. It just, yeah, there was just too many animations. There we go. Yeah, I guess they were just sitting in there. All right, there we go. There's the base set. Okay. So, let's pull back up the blend spaces. Rifle strafe run 45 left loop. Okay. Rifle strafe run 45 left loop, which is this one. So I'm going to right click on this one and go to browse to asset here. It's this one here, so I'm going to right click on it and go to re-import. And that one will be the run 45 that I pulled in. And he is rotated in X, not 90 degrees, so I'll come down in here, and in the import stuff, in X, I'll just type in 90, and then re-import animation. There we go. Alright, so when I scroll here, homeboy's doing his run, okay? So I can pull some of these other ones in here that I've already got. For example, this one is run backwards loop, and this one is run backwards loop. So let's find those, which is run backwards loop. Browse to asset, right click, re-import with new file, we'll put those in downloads. So this one is running backwards. Alright, and this one I assume we'll probably have to do 90 degrees also. Re-import animation. Now we'll do the run forward loop. Browse to asset. Re-import with new file. We'll do standard run. We'll have to do 90 on this one. And then we'll do the two strafes. So let's see where the strafes are. This one is, oh, that's not it. Right, this is backwards. Strafe run 135. Okay, here we go. Strafe run left loop. Strafe run left loop. So let's find that. Well, here's strafe run left loop. So browse to asset. Okay, right click on it. Re-import with new file. Left strafe. And I'll go ahead and do the right one while in there, which is strafe right loop. Re-import with new file. Right strafe. And I'll double click on those. Again, 90 and X. Re-import. And then left. 90 and X, re-import. Alright, so now let's take a look at what we got here. Okay, so he's got his run backwards, and as I hold shift, I can slide through here. And we're starting to get it. Right, he's got his backwards run, he's got his forwards run, he's got his right run, and he's got another backwards run. I don't see where the strafes are, though. Strafe run right loop. Oh, I screwed that up. I pulled in the wrong animations. That's okay. The good news is we're only worried about the runs. So I need strafe run right loop. Strafe. Rifle strafe. Rifle strafe. Rifle strafe run left loop. Okay, here we go. Re-import with new file. So I pulled them in over the wrong animations, that's okay. And this is the right. So let's see, right strafe. Now I need to bend them 90 degrees. So 90 and X. Re-import. And this one, 90 as well. So now when I click on this, now let's look. All right, so he's got his backwards run. He's got his run, I guess, that's the strafe left. Then he turns a little bit for his right, and then he goes through. So I'm starting to get all these in here. See how this is working? But we need to go through now. We're missing this animation, that animation, and that animation, which is basically, so we've done the the run diagonal this way, we need to do the run forward run diagonal this way, then we need to do a reverse, then we need to pull in the reverse run and do it this way, then the reverse run and do it this way. Then once we import those over the proper ones in here, this guy's run blends will be totally done. So then all we do is just go to save all. And oh yeah, one other step. So all of these animations that got pushed into content, under each guy, I have Vampire Dude here, I've got an animations folder. We're gonna put all these in movement. So I'm just gonna drag them all, pull them over into movement, move here. Okay, save all. Close and reel. Now what do we do before we push anything? Pull. Alright, go into Atomic Assault and Git Sync, do a pull. Now I'm going to do a git commit master, and let's see what we got here. Lots of stuff. So lots of stuff was created. All this is vampire movement stuff, so I'm just going to click all. What's that? Base humanoid here? Nope. We didn't make any adjustments to base humanoid, so I'm going to right-click on it and hit revert. Characters vampire dude. I did do stuff to that. I think I did. I didn't change the skeleton at all, but when you add animations and stuff, it affects the skeleton. And then we have my Maya files in here. I have an idle, which... I'm not worried about that right now. I'll push it anyway. Well, no, I'm not. Right click on this idle. I can't revert it, so I'm just going to turn it off. I did do the run 35. This werewolf thing is something else. Alright, so. Let's see. Added. Vampire. Dude. Run. Animations. Okay. Commit and push. And then we'll just let that go through. Any questions?
Yeah, when can I die?